Let's look at some numbers for Bhuvi from the time he started, because his career has gone through a few phases. When he started, he was predominantly this big banana in-swing bowler, isn't it? Remember that
That's right.
When he was curling that ball back in. Percentage of balls in the first spell is very interesting. 78% he used to bowl in that first full spell.
Yeah.
Now, you can understand why he's bowling fewer as you go along, because he's become a better death bowler.
Absolutely.
As he's gone along.
Yes.
But what do you make of that strike rate? Since Jan 2017, he's only got 19 wickets from 37 matches in his first spell, which was a quality of Bhuvi. He used to get wickets in that first spell, didn't he?
And that's something, you know, which has been his strength.
Yeah.
And that's something which if he's not able to realize that, you know, someone needs to have that kind of word with him. You know, so you got to put pressure on yourself as a bowler to have that kind of mindset when you're starting the innings. Because every time I look at Bhuvneshwar, for me, Bhuvneshwar Kumar's strength is to bowl with the new ball. You know, if he's bowling at the death and doing a good job, it's fantastic. You know, it's a added advantage. But his base strength will always be bowling with that new ball, creating that kind of pressure and you know, provide that support to Bumrah as well. So if Bumrah is picking that one wicket and Bhuvneshwar consistently taking that one wicket in the first spell, then that's going to change the whole tone of the match. Like, you know, your platform is set. You're talking about how your top three have been so consistent in terms of, you know, providing that kind of platform for the middle order. So in the similar way as bowling partnership, you got to consistently provide that two wicket platform for your Kuldeep or the spinner which is playing in the middle orders to create that pressure.
Zach, could it be, I mean, in modern day cricket, I don't know how it works. Would it be because you see those numbers when we saw Jasprit Bumrah had an arrival as the bowler in the team, and the role that he's playing now has changed. He's probably become the wicket-taking bowler. Do teams work like that in today's time, where
I think
the length changes and you've got to play a supporting role? Is that a possibility?
I think it's another interesting thing when you look at Bhuvneshwar Kumar is his percentage of slower ones bowled in the first 10 overs, which like first 5 or 6 overs which he bowls, has gone up drastically. You know, so when you're bowling those slower ones, you know, when you're bowling those cutters, you're bowling those knuckle balls, you're obviously not allowing the ball to swing, right? Like, you know, you're taking the swing away from your own armory, and that's something which has been his strength. So he has to find that right balance of having that kind of mindset in terms of picking wickets, rather than, you know, changing that bat swing, that, you know, that speed change, speed variation, you know, which he's been relying on to get wickets. Like if you'll see the wickets which he's taken also has been off the knuckle ball.
Now, which kind of Bhuvi do we like? Because from being a predominantly early overs bowler to being one of the better death bowlers, there's been a bit of a transformation. Let's look at the numbers for Bhuvneshwar later on. If you see initially, economy rate at the end was 7.86. That economy rate has actually come down to 6.62. Maybe the number of wickets has grown a little bit as well. But is he a better bowler overall? Because there have been phases in Bhuvi's life. He started off as sort of medium pace swing bowler. Then he actually put on pace and lost the swing. And in his best phase, before he got this injury, he was actually swinging the ball at pace. Which is the best situation?
He's a complete package, and he's a smart bowler. You know, he falls under that category where he knows his strengths well, he reads the game well, he understands what are the batsman's strength and how I can counter that. So that's something which has been his strength, and that's why the numbers are reflecting that they've progressively been getting better in terms of the economy rate. Because, you know, when you're playing white ball cricket, your first priority always is to look good in terms of the economy rate. You know, that shouldn't put pressure on you. You've seen the case of Umesh Yadav, which we've been discussing. The guy has been consistently picking up wickets, but the economy rate has been hampering in terms of his spot in the team. So that's something as a bowler always plays on your mind. And with Bhuvneshwar, the numbers are also suggestive that, you know, he's been thinking about the game.
You know, when Bhuvi first came, you worried. You saw there was Manoj Prabhakar, who started off as a medium pace, actually put on pace a little bit before he finished. Then there was Praveen Kumar, who by the time his career finished was swinging the ball beautifully, but batsmen could even adjust their shots. He had lost so much pace. Do you think that contributed to Bhuvi trying to say, I will not lose pace, I need that extra nip, that extra pace?
I think most players, once they get into a side or somebody who started bowling swing, want to bowl as fast as they can. And once you get into the side, you get to spend time with, you know, other bowlers who played in the past. You train differently. I think he's worked towards his game. He's one of those, like you said, he's an intelligent bowler. I'd say he's one who's a growing person. There are cricketers who come into Indian cricket. There's only one that I can, two now, that I can think of when they started their careers, and when they finished, they were all heavier. There are only two people. Rahul Dravid comes to mind, one who was as fit as he was from day one till the last day, and Virat Kohli. These are two names that come. Generally, players who get better are ones who are keep improving, adding to their game, and I think Bhuvneshwar has done that. He would like you said, ideally you want the pace and the swing. But the way you release the ball, whatever your action is, there is an optimum speed at which the ball can swing. So if you go faster than that, because the distance is the same, I mean, you can't change the physics of, you know, the game and the ball. So that there is a point where you have to find your own length and your own line, which Bhuvneshwar has been able to find it again. But he can't do it again now because what he said, it's not happening in the last few games. Is because that point has changed. Where you release that ball has gone, I think, back. He'd be better to tell you. Because where you release it makes a huge difference. And I think that point of release is what is missing from...
Last point on Bhuvi, actually, before we move on. You thought he needed more bowling. And I know white and red cricket, ball cricket is completely different. Would he almost be better off going and bowling long spells for UP? Go and play a Ranji Trophy game, go get a couple of long spells in?
It all depends on the real reason exactly. Yeah. Like, you know, if you are carrying a niggle, then you're better off not bowling that much. You know, you have to manage it. You have to first get fit and then start building up those bowling workloads. If there is no physical problem, if your physical fitness is fine, then yes, then you have to get your rhythm going, because right now the rhythm is what is missing. You know, the timing of the delivery, what Ajay is talking about, is missing. Now, how do you achieve that? There's only one way of achieving that, is going in the match situation, going in the nets, and just keep bowling till the time you get it right.